Hi, and welcome back to the PySQL online course. This video is going to be all about transpose functions. We're going to cover what they are, why to use them, and how to make them in PI OLEDB Enterprise. Let's begin by opening up PySQL Commander. Let's begin by connecting to the AF server under the PI OLEDB Enterprise data sources. Let's start by writing a query that gets every element based on the boiler template. The element template name can be found from the element template table, so let's execute a predefined query. This is a template we're interested in, so now we know we have the right table. Next, let's join the elements table. Our join condition can be found by looking at the columns. Here we see that element template has an ID column, and element has an element template ID column. Let's use those in the join. Finally, let's add a where clause to filter down for just boiler. Great, we return 16 rows, and it contains all the different elements based on the boiler template. Finally, let's get the attribute values of every attribute on all of these elements. To do this, we'll join the element attribute table as well as the data.snapshot table. The basis for this query can be found by right-clicking on the snapshot table under the data schema and executing the predefined query. Let's grab the bottom half of this query and add it to our existing one. Predefined query was using the element hierarchy table, but we're using the element table so that we can get the element template ID. Let's change the join condition to match that of the element table. Now let's change the select statement to just get the information that we want. Let's execute this query. Here we see all the snapshot times and snapshot values of the attributes on each of these elements, for a total of 336 rows. This is found because we have 21 attributes on each of the elements. So there's 21 rows for B499. Then the next 21 rows are for B209. As we scroll through the results set, we can see that these values are all there, however the format of the output is not very digestible. Since all of these elements follow the same template and have all of the same attributes, we should be able to view them on 16 rows with 21 different columns, one for each attribute. This is the purpose of a transpose function. Let's create one now and see what it looks like. As I mentioned in a previous video, the data T schema is blank by default. To create a new transpose function, right-click on data T, new transpose function. As seen in the menu, the two options are dynamic or custom, and asset or event frame. Asset corresponds to element templates, whereas event frame corresponds to event frame templates. Dynamic versus custom is the difference between all attributes created from the template, which is dynamic, versus being able to specify which attributes you would like to add to the transpose function output, which is custom. We'll start by doing dynamic. We'll create a snapshot transpose function and select the boiler template. All of our attributes are root level attributes, so in this menu, we'll select just the root path for the attribute. Selecting values as variants will cause the transpose function to return variant as the data type for all the attributes. And create function table will create the function table as well as table value function. Some SQL applications are not compatible with functions, therefore the function table will be necessary to run the query in those applications. We recommend creating the function table in addition to table value function, just in case you ever need it. Let's click Next and execute the query. Great. Now let's refresh both our function tables and our table value functions. Notice that we now see the boiler. In a new query, let's execute the transpose snapshot function. As we can see, the output has 16 rows, one for each element, and all the columns are the different attribute values. So we scroll through, we can see that all the attribute values are there, and that the previous query returned the same data, however, in a much different format. This format is much easier to understand and is also much easier to digest by other formats. This format is also easily turned into a CSV. Next, let's look at the difference between the function table and the table value function. Notice in the table value function, we've cross-applied the transpose function to the elements that were found by filtering by element template type of boiler. With the function table, we're seeing the same output, however, we're joining it as if it were a table. Next, let's create a custom transpose function for the same template so that we can show some summary values. Let's right-click on data T again, new transpose function, custom transpose function. Here we'll select transpose summarize because we want to obtain summary values. We'll select the boiler template again, and here we'll drag the attributes on that we would like. Let's get fuel gas flow, process feed rate, and water flow. Let's obtain the average for fuel gas flow, as well as process feed rate, and the min, max, and standard deviation of water flow. We'll click Next and create the transpose function. Now let's query the summarize table for the boiler. The predefined query uses a 1-hour time range with 30-minute time steps, so we see 2 rows per element. Let's change this to only 1 row. Notice here that we have 16 rows, one for each element, and we have the average of both the fuel gas flow and the process feed rate, as well as the water flow, min, max, and standard deviation for the last hour. Now, just as a note, the new green database maps all the different attributes, the different elements, to the same PI tag. That's why we see the same values here. They're all mapped to our built-in tags. That way, everything will work. On your systems, the different elements should have different values. Now, what if we wanted one query output to have the 5 summary values shown here, in addition to the snapshot values we saw in the previous query? Let's create that now. Let's copy each query into the corresponding portion of the combined query. In both query outputs, we can see that the element path and name has been provided. This can be our join. In both cases, it's provided as the name element, which, if we were to have 2 of them, would cause a naming conflict. So let's change that now to element and element 2. We'll create the join. One of our attributes is pointing to the wrong server, so let's fix that now. And let's run it again. Here we see 16 rows, one for each element, and we have all of the different current values of all the attributes, and at the end, we have all of the summary values provided from the summaries table. Now, this is a fairly verbose query, so if we're going to use this in a production system, it's probably best to create a view. Let's do that now. Under the data T schema, let's right-click on views and create view. Let's copy everything from the query window, paste it as a view definition. Let's change the view name and execute it. Refresh our views and execute the view itself. Now we have a two-line query that produces one element on each row, as well as all the current values and summary values for the last hour for each of the attributes. This concludes the video on transpose functions, and I encourage you to repeat this process using the event frame templates. Thanks for watching.